Hello, everyone. Did you have a good old neighbor? Nikki can frozen into a Noah Panda Die fan to that one, you know. And today, I'm doing my ranking of the Saw movie. Yes, people, I'm not a huge fan of this franchise because, honestly, guys, I can handle some blood and gore in my stomach. But I'm just not a huge fan of seeing the characters being tortured and all, etc. And having trap on them and tearing apart. Yeah, I'm just not a huge fan of it. Honestly, I can handle some horror theme, but Lionsgate took the Saw movie way too seriously and took it way too far. So thank to Toby Bell who survived this franchise. Thank you, Toby Bell. You're a legend. So, hey guys, so today I'm doing my ranking of the Saw movie. Once again, not a huge fan of this franchise, so let me tell you my ranking. So, here we go. Alright, guys, coming in the bottom, and I know a lot of people are going to put this as a last. No surprise, it's had to be Saw 3D, aka Saw the Final Chapter, aka Saw 7, Saw 3D, with. Oh, everything you want to call it. Lionsgate picked the title already. Yeah, this movie is terrible. Every time like we watch this movie, a lot of time, it's just honestly, it's not because how the kill looks terrible, because honestly, the kill is terrible. But the biggest problem of this movie, it has to be the lacking of the blood effects and gore effects. The blood of this movie is pink. Honestly. I know a lot of people is going to say the blood of the movie is pink. Yeah, this movie, the blood is pink. It looks terrible. Yeah, who in the white might want to add blood pink? So that is really disgusting. It's kind of reminds me of like a PG-13 version of the Saw movie. Didn't run it all in NC-17. And sorry, guys. I still have some feel positive about this movie. At least Dr. Gordon was really likable characters in this movie. Well, the first thing was really overacted. Was he in the church? Like, every single Saw characters from the last Saw movies from years ago. So yeah, and at least Lionsgate, at least the director did not ruin Dr. Gordon. So at least Dr. Gordon did pretty good in this movie. And the ending of the film is honestly one of the best ending I ever seen for the Saw movie. Even I'm a fan of Jigsaw, which just came out in 2017. I might get to that in my number one. So yeah. And sorry, guys, and the score of the film is absolutely terrible, absolutely pointless. And so why in the world you ruin to the iconic theme or the Saw theme go to do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do. Oh my, that is my jam. And sorry, guys, and this version is absolutely terrible. And at least they bring up to the original just like the ending. In some trap of this movie, like the car trap looks pretty cool, but overall, we can't forget that the estication trap. OMG, what the director was thinking who making this scene. Who in the white mind want to add a trap featuring Plug Whip? How? I just want to know how they set up the trap. How they set up the trap at the Plug Whip. You abusing people, director, you can't do that. And the biggest problem of this movie, it's had to be the handle of the 3D, because the director don't even care about the story, the characters, or whatever to the character. All they care about 3D. Yeah, this is the main reason why I'm not a huge fan of 3D, because my last 3D movie I saw in theaters has to be Frozen 2. Anyway, Frozen 2 is much better 3D movie. I recommend you watch Frozen 2 in 3D. At least the Frozen 2 3D works much better than the 3D gamut in this movie. Sorry, guys. And that's why Saw 3D is honestly one of the worst Saw movies I have ever seen. And this is hands down one of the worst movies of 2010. This movie is even worse than the last Airbender, darn it. Yeah, this movie is terrible. I don't want to think about this movie. This is stupid. And sorry, guys. And that's why Saw the Final Chapter is in my number 9 on the worst Saw movies in the bottom. It is number 1. Sorry, guys. Now let's get to number 8. Alright, guys. Coming to number 8. It's had to be Saw 6. Just like Saw 3D, I'm just not a huge fan of this movie. Honestly, I'm just not a huge fan of the Saw franchise. And sorry, guys. I'm just not a huge fan of this movie. I don't understand why this movie got good review. And thank God Rotten Tomato gave this movie 1. And once again, every single Saw movie in Rotten Tomato is not doing that good, honestly. And honestly, you gotta stop making Saw movie, because they were really ruining people's life. Like, destroying their body. That's disgusting. And so, yeah. And sorry, guys, and even this movie has some few positives about this movie. So overall, this movie is honestly one of the most overrated movie of 2009. Now let's continue. Now, what's the skip one? Alright, guys, I had to make this fast. Coming to number 7, it's had to be Saw V. Honestly, just not a huge fan of this movie. It's all I gotta say about this movie. The story is awful, the character is stupid, and the trap of the water trap is not creative. It's really completely lazy, and you can't get out of this trap. So let's skip it. Alright, guys, coming to number 6, it's had to be Saw 2. I'm just not a huge fan of this movie because even this movie is way better than Saw, way better than the first Saw movie, which is the number 10 most overrated movie of all time. But still, this movie is a piece of crap. And honestly, at least Tobey Bell as Jigsaw did a pretty good villain. At least the needle trap looks pretty cool. And at least the score got an iconic theme for this movies, anyway. Anyway, guys, and that's why Saw 2 is in my number 6. Now let's get to number 5. Alright, guys, coming to number 5, and this is only the mediocre Saw movie, so don't worry. It's had to be Saw 3. Honestly, this movie is mediocre. At least the freezer trap looks pretty cool, and at least the score looks pretty cool, and at least Tobey Bell as Jigsaw looks pretty cool. Everything about the positive I did is pretty cool. But the story is... Honestly, the story is completely messy. The character is so bland, it's so forgettable. You don't even give a crap about every single character of the film. And I don't want to tell you what the trap is, because the trap of this movie is absolutely disturbing. Sorry, guys, and now let's get to number 4. It's had to be Spiral for the Book of Saw. Honestly, I feel so bad that Chris Rock get treated bad for this movie. It's like Captain Angel and an etc. And the guy said, you know, I don't want to say it because I will get my YouTube to monetize. Anyway, I still have to feel a pause about this movie. At least Chris Rock and Samuel L. Jackson did it pretty good as Marcus Bank and Detective Bank. At least those two characters did not get ruined, because at least Samuel L. Jackson really tried for this performance. But overall, I think Samuel L. Jackson went overboard for that performance. So, like, get ready. You want to play a game? No. Yeah, that scene was absolutely hilarious, and honestly, that's hilarious. And sorry, guys, and some trap of this movie, like the finger trap, is honestly one of my favorite traps of this movie. And yes, I know it's disturbing, but the trap is way better than the opening of the trap, anyway. And at least the blood effect is way better than Saw 3D, I will admit that. And honestly, one of my favorite characters of this movie, his had to be at Detective Bank, performed by Chris Rock. If you don't know what Chris Rock is, this is the same guy that he got smacked by Will Smith. He was in Madagascar, Amsterdam, and now this movie. And the stupid grown-up movie for Chauncey, and the stupid witch movie for Chauncey. Who in my mind wanted to add Chris Rock as a witch movie? And sorry, guys, and the negative I have for this movie, I cannot stand Captain Angel. Every time I see you on the screen, a lot of time, and make me want to strangle her. Man, she is really annoying. I cannot stand her. She's so bratty and so stupid, and she always treat a Detective Blank like a freaking slave than a worker. Are you serious right now? And William, which is a Detective Blank partners, Captain Angel, what were you thinking? Because William, he is a terrible villain. And this is hands down one of the worst Saw villain I have ever seen in my life. And the ending of the film, I never agree with people. The ending of the film is absolutely terrible and make me angry. And that ending is honestly one of the worst ending I have ever seen for a movie, period. And sorry, guys, and that's why Spiral for the Book of Saw is in my number 4. Now let's get to number 3. Honestly, guys, I know a lot of people is going to put this out to number 1. I am sorry, folks. I'm just not a huge fan of this movie. Sorry, guys. Coming to number 3, it's had to be the first Saw movie. The tortures have started it all. This movie is overrated as crap. And this movie was really boring, too. And honestly, I still have a few pause about this movie. At least the bear trap looks pretty cool, because honestly, I really like the bear trap, because the bear trap is when you have your face boom, blow up in your face. Yeah. And Jigsaw as Tobey Bell did it pretty good in this movie. And Billy the Puppet, he did a really good job in this movie. It's way better than Billy the Puppet from the SML. Even though I like Billy the Puppet, but he was really annoying from the SML. Like Saw 1 and Saw 2. And honestly, we can't forget the amazing iconic theme, which is the best horror theme I have ever seen next to The Shining. It has to be do 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 do. Oh my goodness. Honestly, the main reason why I keep watching this is because they have an iconic theme, and I really love that theme. And the ending of the film, and I really enjoy the ending of the film. The ending of the film is really good, too. It's really good. Not bad. But honestly, this is hands down one of the most overrated movies of 2004. The Incredible and Shrek 2 is a much better 2004 movie than this. Anyway, guys, if you're a huge fan of this movie, I can accept your opinion. But for me, this movie is overrated. I'm just not a huge fan of this movie. Even Frozen will agree with me. So, guys, and that's why the first Saw movie, which is the most overrated movie of all time, which is number 10, it's in my number 3. Now let's get to number 2. Honestly, guys, coming to number 2, it's had to be Saw IV. This movie was really okay. It's not the best, but it's okay. There's nothing to say about this movie. The story was completely messy. The character is completely bland and forgettable. And some of this movie is terrible. Sorry, guys. Now let's get to number 1. Honestly, the number 1 best Saw movie that we've ever gotten has to be Jigsaw. Oh, my goodness. This is hands down one of the most original Saw movies I have ever seen in my life. This movie is very original. They take the Saw 3D and make it to that really great one. And this could be a really epic conclusion to the Saw franchise. This movie is very amazing. The story is so greatness, and the character is so unforgettable. And some trap of this movie is really creative. And I really love this movie. Like the razor trap, and the soaker-raining trap, and the bucket head trap. Kind of look like Plankton from Chum Buggy. and Tobey Bell is Jigsaw. Thank God he redeemed himself to that awful Saw 3D from 2010. But honestly, I still have some one negative I have for this movie. It has to be the ending. The ending of the film, I definitely agree with people. I'm not a huge fan of the ending because he did not say game over. He said, I speak from the dead and close the door and that's the movie end. Are you serious right now? Dude, you're supposed to say game over. Honestly, that's a point for a Saw movie. You gotta say game over. When you said, I speak from the dead, honestly, it's kind of reminded me of Walking Dead in an actual Saw movie. What the heck? And so, guys, the one character of this movie, which is a blonde girl, I honestly cannot stand. So, thank God she died. She deserved it. And so, overall, guys, and that's why Jigsaw is honestly one of my number one best Saw movie I have ever seen in my life. And I cannot wait to see Saw 10. So, you guys, that was my ranking of the Saw movie. Tell me what your ranking of the Saw movie. And you can tell me you haven't seen it, so don't watch it because it's disgusting. And so, guys, I gotta get down and eat because it's almost shower time. And after that, I gotta do bandages on my foot with my mom. And so, guys, if you like this, you wanna play a game video, please hit the subscribe button, turn on the notification, and share for the video for whole fam for ages. And stay tuned for my rant on Texas Chainsaw 3D. And stay tuned for my movie review of Randy and Wild. I'm going to watch that movie this morning. And I will rewatch Last Night in Soho. And I might do my dog Last Night in Soho on the rewatch tomorrow morning. So stay tuned. And so, guys, I'm done for today. This is all the video you're going to get this morning. So, yeah, subscribe, comment, share with family. And I see you next time. It's all Wonkin. Peace, YouTube.